Hi, kindergarten. Today I'm going to teach you about a saint who I love very much and who has brought me a lot of comfort. So today, May 13th, is the feast day of a very special saint, Saint Julian of Norwich. She was a woman who lived in England a long, long time ago in the Middle Ages, during a time that was similar to ours right now. A very bad illness called the bubonic plague was sweeping the world, making everyone sick. Julian believed that she had seen God and Jesus, and they had given her visions of their love. Julian decided to become an anchoress, who is a person who lives inside a little room in a church and doesn't come out and prays for everyone around her. People don't do this very much anymore, but in St. Julian's time, this was pretty normal. Does the idea of going into your house and not coming out remind you of what we're doing right now? Julian is a good example to us of how we can pray and find God's love even when we are stuck inside our houses. So on this page I wanted to show you, this is a statue of St. Julian that's located on the side of the church where she had her room, but this is a modern statue. This was just recently carved in the year 2000. This is a picture of St. Julian's actual church. Her original cell, or the room that she lived in, was destroyed a long time ago because it was such an old church. So this little room was built in about the same place hers was, so people could see what her little room was like. And that is kind of a recreation of her room. So I want to show you, there are a lot of different images of St. Julian. They didn't have cameras at the time when she lived, so people have had to rely on their imagination of what she looked like and from other people's paintings of her at the time. You can see that her head is covered. She lived kind of a humble life, so she didn't want to show off her clothes or show off her hair, so she covered her hair and she wore simple clothes. In a lot of the icons, she's shown with a cat because even though anchoresses couldn't live with other people, they lived by themselves, they were allowed to have a cat, so almost always when you see a picture or an icon of St. Julian, she has a cat with her. So I want to read you some of the things she wrote down. She wrote her visions down, her visions of how God and Jesus love us so much, in a book called Revelations of Divine Love. And this is one of the things she wrote that I love that she wrote. And in this, God showed me a little thing, the quantity of a hazelnut. See this little nut? That's a hazelnut. Lying in the palm of my hand, it seemed, and it was as round as any ball. I looked thereupon with the eye of my understanding, that means she looked at it to figure out what it was, and I thought, what may this be? And it was answered generally thus, it is all that is made. I wondered how it could last, for I thought it might suddenly fall to nothing for no reason. And I was answered in my understanding, it lasts, and ever shall, for God loves it. And so everything has its beginning by the love of God. In this little thing I saw three properties. The first is that God made it. The second is that God loves it. And the third is that God keeps it. And so what she is saying is that when God showed her this little hazelnut, and she said, what is that? He said, that's the whole universe. That's everything I created. And she said, it looks so small. How come it doesn't just fall apart? And he says, it exists because I love it and I wanted it to be and I take care of it. And I find a lot of comfort in that. And then she also said, all shall be well and all shall be well and all manner of things shall be well. For there is a force of love moving through the universe that holds us strongly and will never let us go. So today for your work, I want you to make your own sign that says, all shall be well. You can write it in your best handwriting. And then I would like you to decorate it with some beautiful pictures. You could put flowers, you could put rainbows, you could put stars, you could put rock stars, you could put alligators, whatever you think is a joyful and a calming picture for other people to see. And then when you've made it really beautiful, you can put your sign up in your window where other people will see it and they'll say, oh yeah, God is taking care of us. All shall be well. All right. I hope you have a fun time with this kindergarten, and I hope you like learning about St. Julian. I will talk to you later. Bye.